Welcome back. This is going to be our very first video in a sequence of video series that you will probably see throughout the course for our Organic Chemistry 1 class. And Organic Chemistry 1 is the first, obviously, the first course in a sequence of two courses that most science majors have to take in college. Okay, so welcome to the course. Where do I really start? That was the question, okay? Because it is such a massive subject, just like any other chemistry area. I gave a lot of thought on really where I should start my class with. And here's what I came up with. So let's start with defining what is organic chemistry really is. Because you don't want to go through the class, and if somebody you talk to in the lobby or at a food shop or cafe and ask you, hey, what is organic chemistry? Because they're more curious to know what it really is. And you can't say, oh, it's CH3, it's CH2. They would ask, what is organic chemistry? Okay, if you can't give them a definition, more likely, even if you've got an A in that class, then you can consider yourself you've got an F in the class. In the person's view, you didn't even know what the subject meant, but you've learned the subject. So I felt, well, that's my starting point. That's my anchor point to start my videos. All right, organic chemistry is a chemistry, a branch of chemistry, but because I'm writing here, I'm not going to write everything I say. Chemistry, that's a branch of chemistry studying. Obviously, it's not going to be perfectly grammatical, but who cares? Chemistry studying carbon compounds. If you can answer that person that asks you that question at a cafe or wherever you run into that person, asks you what is organic chemistry, if you tell them, hey, it's a chemistry studying carbon compounds. Bingo. Four-word definition. I mean, obviously, that's grammatically wrong. But meaning-wise, it's correct. All right, so if you look at, and then I've already told you last class, why are you in the class, okay? Yes, of course, you have to have an overall worldwide view of science, and organic chemistry plays a vital role towards that worldwide view. That's one of the reasons why you're taking the class. But the second most important reason is if you decide to branch out into any of the professional medicinal areas of any kind, you would need organic chemistry 1 and 2, general chemistry 1 and 2, because if you're going to appear for their board exams, then they have a component of organic chemistry written into their exams. Okay? So, and I've shown you through videos and examples that how organic chemistry is such a vital in our day-to-day life in our very first class. Okay? So, pretty much everything we consume, everything we drink, everything we eat, and the medicines that we take, everything is got organic chemistry written all over it. But if you dig deep into anything that you eat or consume that has an organic compound, you notice that that compound's got carbon in it. Okay? Carbon is such a unique and ubiquitous element that it's just about everywhere. Okay, it's omnipresent. Okay, it's omnipresent. Means it's present everywhere. Just about everything you dig, there is at least one carbon, unless it's an ionic compound or a transition metal compound, which we won't get into because, again, this is not an inorganic chemistry class. This is an organic chemistry class. All right, so this introduction part is getting a little longer, so I'm going to cut straight to the chase. Okay, so to start off with, we're going to look at three broader, okay, range of compounds called alkanes, alkenes, okay, and alkynes. Why do I start off with this? Because one way or the other, a great deal of compounds contain carbons that are in one of these three families. Okay, alkanes, alkenes, and alkynes. Okay, we're going to spend a considerable amount of time talking over each of these family of carbon compounds, okay? These are all part of a family of carbon compounds, okay? Very good. All right? So let's start off with something basic. All right? So you've got, okay, a carbon. Okay? Let's start with the carbon itself because that's the anchoring point around which the entire organic chemistry revolves. Okay? Now, before we go even further into compound, just let's dig deep. Again, occasionally I might quiz you on your general chemistry 1 and 2 as we do these videos. Okay? If you know a bond, it's a realistic bond, a covalent bond, has got 2 electrons. Okay? Every bond has got 2 electrons. Okay? Now, if you notice, where is carbon in the periodic table? Where is carbon in the periodic table? If you notice, it's under group 4A. What does 4A means? Well, let me answer that question really quick. Okay? That means it's got, carbon has 4 valence electrons. Okay? The electrons that are available for use. But if you actually look at the atomic number of carbon, it is 6. So, 2 of those electrons are never available out of the 6 for bonding. Only 4 electrons are available for bonding, okay? Okay? Very good. Now, if you also know, there is something called group 8A. And what does that mean? That means carbon can take 4 more electrons. Now, these are 4 individual electrons. You cannot make a bond with it. We've already established that. You need 2 electrons to make a single bond, right? Very good, right? So that means it needs 4 more electrons. Whatever it bonds with, it would have to have equal number of whatever it's got. So if it has 4 to start with, it needs 4 more, okay? That only you will have a bond, right? If you're going to have 4 bonds, you'll have 8 electrons, which makes sense because 4 plus 4 equals 8 electrons, right? So that's the very, very basic place where we will start this class. And you will see when we are in video 120, look where you have come, okay? But I don't know how many of you have a concrete understanding of this from your general chemistry 1 and 2. And if you don't, well, this is a time I gave you a quick snapshot of why carbon has so many bonds and why it is the way it is, all right? So in its natural state, okay, let's give a quick synopsis of those 3 families of carbon compounds. Let's start with the alkanes, okay? They have only single bonds, okay? Let's start with that. We don't need to even go into the others as soon as I finish this. So I said it's single bonds, right? So any compound that's part of the organic alkane family will only have carbon. The compound might look as complex or as simple, but it doesn't matter. We cannot violate trends. That means whatever on this side is what it's bonded to, okay? So I'm going to put these, okay? But if you noticed, the 1 electron from each carbon, these are the electrons from the carbon. Carbon itself doesn't have 8 electrons. Carbon only can donate 4 electrons, but it would, in the process, due process, would take 4 electrons from another atom. Actually, I am going to delete this in blue color. I'm going to pick a different color so that I can show you the difference on what I'm really talking about. So this right here, okay, this red electron does not belong to carbon. It belongs to whatever element it's pairing with, and alkanes, okay, typically alkanes itself means it only contains two types of elements, and that is carbon and hydrogen, okay? We will add alkanes, and then we would add an alcoholic group to it, a chlorine to it, which is part of the halogen family, or we could add other elements to the basic foundation, okay? But let me write, okay? Typically this, you will hear me say this so many times. Typically means for the most case, okay? Okay, alkanes contain, okay, carbon and hydrogen. Let's start with there because we're not in our set, in our 100th video, okay? We're on our very first video, okay? Now, if you also notice, okay, hydrogen, which is in group 1A in the periodic table, that means it only has one valence electron to lose. Well, it only has one electron total and also has one valence electrons, okay? What that means is, say if carbon were to combine, if carbon and hydrogen were to combine, to make a simplest of the simple compound in organic chemistry. This is probably the most simplest compound you probably will come across in the entire course, okay? You would start to see that the compounds become bigger and bigger and bigger as we get further in the course. All right, so carbon, we've already established it. It's got four, it should have four bonds in the, if it's part of the alkane family. And we know that, let me get a different color. Actually, since I have red, I'm gonna use carbon is only got four electrons to share, but it needs four on other ends to make a compound, right? Now, hydrogen has one valence electrons. Now, if only one hydrogen were to bond with the carbon, that means you will have a bunch of loose ends that are not filled up, right? So I'm gonna get my blue back, okay? So, hydrogen has one electron to share. Now, as I said, if carbon has four valence electrons, by due process, it would pair in such a way that it will pair with four elements or something that already has four electrons to offer right away. So, each hydrogen would offer one of its electrons. That means four hydrogens have to combine with the carbon, okay, which leads to CH4. So the compound's formula is one carbon, and we normally put however many that element is on the bottom, and this, folks, is known as methane, which is a gas that's used for fuel, right? This is the most simplest compound, okay? So the take-home message on this particular video is, okay, carbon, whether it's part of the alkane, alkyne, or alkene family, okay, can only have, okay, four bonds, okay? That means eight total electrons. Doesn't matter which organic course you are in, doesn't matter what you're learning in organic chemistry, you cannot ever violate this rule right here. Let me put it in red just to caution you on what I'm really talking about here. So, four bonds, this is important, okay? We will study those three families much more closer. But it doesn't matter where you are on the family, whether it's alkanes, alkenes, or alkynes, carbon can never have three bonds. It cannot have four, it cannot have five bonds, it cannot have six, it cannot have two. Trust me, I have seen a garden variety of carbon with a garden variety of bonds, okay? I cannot emphasize this to you. You will see that I will never violate in my lecture on all these compounds throughout the course, that I would never write a carbon with four bonds, not write hydrogen with two bonds, okay? Hydrogen can only be in a single bond, okay? Hydrogen can only have one bond with any element it's paired with, all right? And carbon can only have four bonds. All right, so that's our very first introductory video. I'm gonna stop here and then I'm gonna come back with the next content in this sequence, all right? Stay tuned.